We're back, bitches! I mean, ladies, we're back. Welcome to all of you that are here. Everybody come on in, grab a seat. Plenty of comfy chairs. My name's Lisa Ann Pinkerton, founder and chairwoman of Women in Clean Tech and Sustainability, and we are so excited to have you here because the last time we all gathered together for an event like WCS Talks, it was in 2019. Feels like it was ages ago, right? And so we're super excited to have you here today. Thank you all for coming out. I know you could be anywhere today. You could be doing anything. You could be working. So thank you for being here today. Give yourselves a round of applause. Thank you, too, for your employers allowing us to share you for the afternoon. And we also want to thank our sponsors, because without them, we wouldn't be here either. So we definitely want to thank Plug and Play for being here and hosting us today, as well as Aurora Solar, First Solar, GAF Energy, Silicon Valley Bank, TerraSmart, the keg that we will be enjoying later. At the reception upstairs is from Alpha Acid Brewing Company, so that's pretty awesome. And we've got some beer and champagne flutes from Sustainable Agave Company. So thank them all for supporting us. Yes, you heard right, champagne upstairs. That's why we're all really here, right? Champagne and cupcakes. This is a monumentous moment, and we're, you know, so happy to be back on the stage and have in-person events again. And I know that this year hasn't been as happy for some of us, especially when you think about what happened in June with the Supreme Court, and I'm not going to go into all that bullshit, but it reminded me a lot of why we do what we do and why we gather together and why we create community. Things like that Supreme Court decision can make you feel angry and frustrated and depressed. And it can make you feel like you're powerless. But that's only an illusion. Maybe you don't have as much power, or maybe we as a group don't have as much power as perhaps we would like to have or could use. And so how do we create more of what we want? The way we do that, in my opinion, frankly, is by showing up as a leader and developing influence that you can then use as energy to create whatever it is you want to see in the world. How many of you have ideas that you would like to create for this world? Anybody? All right, cool. If you don't, maybe you'll get some ideas here today. So this is the thing. No one's going to give you power, right? And also, taking it isn't the best thing either, because that assumes a zero-sum game. So what we want to do is cultivate power alongside people who currently hold power. And as we share power, it grows and the influence grows, right? This is how our grandmothers and great-grandmothers were able to get the right to vote. It wasn't that they deserved it or what have you. Well, of course we deserve it, but that argument wasn't what actually got them over the line. It was that the female perspective was a virtuous perspective and deserved to have a voice. So they tried multiple different arguments to finally get men to share power with them, and that's the one that worked. So, how do we cultivate power? You start by being a leader. You can show up as a leader in multiple ways. You can start small, at home, by, you know, leading your family to do certain things, or teaching your kids to do certain things, like, you know, I'm not going to do your laundry anymore, you're 16 years old. Have at it. You're not doing mine, but you can do yours. Ensuring that you've got real partnership with the people that you live with, right? You don't have to carry everything on your shoulders. That's leadership. Taking that initiative. As a friend, you can take initiative. Organizing events. Or having those tough conversations with your friends. Or mediating a disagreement between friends, right? At work, this shows up like taking the initiative because you have an idea and your superior says, you know what, that sounds great. Would you like to do that? And then raising your hand and saying yes. Volunteering your time. All of these things put you in an environment where you can start acting as a leader. And the more you act as a leader, the more you start to notice, oh, hey, I'm actually pretty good at this. Maybe I'll take on something a little bit bigger, right? And when you do that, your brain starts to calculate, like, oh, hey, we have confidence. Oh, hey, this is safe for us to do. Oh, hey, people like us when we do this kind of thing. Let me do more of it. Let me do something bigger. Let me play a bigger game. Now, of course, there are going to be people who say, you need to stay in your lane. Or don't do any more than you're getting paid for. Or make sure you save time for you. That's all great. Like, welcome to do all those things. There's nothing, I'm not saying one is better than the other. But what I'm saying is, what I have noticed about this reality is that when you play a bigger game, you have more options. And you have, frankly, more enjoyment sometimes, I think. Not all the time. Sometimes it really feels like you're living life on hard mode. You're like, why did I commit to all these things? Why did I decide to have an idea and then execute on it? Could be doing my yoga right now, but no. Anyway, so WCS itself was born out of that experience, right? Me saying, you know, looking around and thinking, oh, somebody else will start this organization, or there's already organizations, so I don't need to do it, and like hemming and hawing about it, and having friends that were like, you know what, you should just do it. And I'm like, I don't know. And then one day I was like, you know what, fuck it, I'm doing it. So we're here because I had that moment, right? And all of you may have those moments at some point in your life, and I'm here to tell you, go for it. Go for it. Because the world rewards initiators. It rewards creators. You don't have to be any of those things. Your life could be perfectly happy doing other stuff, and that's fine. And if you want to play a bigger game, and you have some ideas, you have a world that you want to create, you have everything in your power to do it. It's right there for the taking. Just have to make the decision, the choice to do it, and the commitment, because this world also rewards consistency. Showing up and consistency. Where do you think we would be right now if Mr. Elon Musk decided, you know what, it's just too much effort. It's going to be too hard to build an electric vehicle company, and it's going to be too expensive, and I just don't have the time. Where would we be, right? He is an example of greatness that you can create. So, play a bigger game. How do we do this? We show up as leaders. How do we do that? Start with having a world that you want to create. Could be big or small. And then start talking to other people about it. Try it out. Test it out. See what they think. Start to develop followers. And then initiate. Look for the openings. Sometimes at work, you want to make sure you've got the invitation. And the invitation can be very small. But that gives you the opening. That way, you might not come across as just sort of like the battering ram, like go in and do. I used to do that, actually. And then I learned that that's not the way to do it. Anyway, so this is what we do. As we continue to lead and we show up as leaders, then we start to gather influence. Influence then grows and multiplies the more you leverage it and the more you create it for all of the people around you. And you can also create influence with relationships and building those relationships and bringing in people with influence to champion what you're doing. Again, collaboration, co-creating is what we do. So, I appreciate you listening to me talk about this because I feel like in 2022, as women, we don't really have the luxury of sitting around and allowing ourselves to be on the sidelines or assuming that somebody else is going to do it for us. Like, there's no Prince Charming, just here to tell you. He doesn't exist. You are your own Prince Charming. So, don't ask for permission. Just go ahead and do what you want to do, as long as it's within the flow, right? Like, you see openings, you see opportunities, go for them. Ask people in positions of power to co-create with you. Share your ideas with them. Get their feedback. Figure out, do you think this thing might work? Oh, yeah, I think it'll work, but I think you need to do X, Y, and Z. Here's the strategy, right? And then, of course, dedicate your time to it. Consistency, saving time to do the things that you want to do. Here at WCS, we don't, what's the word I'm looking for? We don't necessarily accept the phrase, I just don't have enough time to do that. Join the fucking club. None of us have enough time to do anything. We're all full up. But what do? We carve out time. We make time. We protect time. Because nature abhors a vacuum. So if you have a hole in your time schedule, it's going to get filled up. So stop thinking that someone else is going to do it for you. Stop thinking that you need to stay in your lane. Or that if you're just really good at your job, somebody will notice you, right? And start playing a bigger game. Go beyond voting. Obviously, we all want to vote. I don't care who you vote for, but I really, really care that you use that right that our great-grandmothers got for us. Share your voice. Participate in organizations that are bigger than yourselves. Doesn't matter what it could be. Could be WCS, could be something else. It doesn't matter. But be a part of your community. You're not a helpless victim. Prince Charming's not going to come rescue you. You get to do it yourself. Because you are all creators. You are all leaders. Leader, 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 badass leader, leader, kicking ass over there. You're also queens. You're goddesses. You are consciousness in a meat sack walking around on this planet. It's amazing. So enjoy your life and use it and play a bigger game because why the fuck not? Okay, I'm done. Thanks.